boys, football is again.
It back. Is.
Oh, a round of applause, everyone. I don't care who you are. I don't care if you like the sport. You better just goddamn clap your hands because this is the best time of the
country. W's in the chat, yes. Baby. What's going on, y'all? And welcome back to another edition with the Brotherhood of Ball. I'm your host, Clayton, joined by DJ and Mr. Olsen. What's up, boys?
We are back. It is good to be back, boys.
How's it going, y'all? We missed you. Yes. We're back on schedule.
Come on.
Things are going to be rolling,
Let's
baby.
Let's go. We're going to get things rolling, kicked off. It's been a minute, but we're back on track. We're going to be talking about a few topics today. The Hall of Fame game coming up. First preseason. We'll dive into a little bit of that. We're going to dive into all the Olympics that have been going on. That's been a fun time to watch. Go Team USA. We love that. Also be getting into the Creator Classic coming on, a new phenom that's basically getting YouTube players to get into the PGA events. And lastly, we're going to be talking about the new college football game that is raving across not only the U.S., but all over the world. People are happy. People are ecstatic. But without further ado, let's get on in.
Starting off this episode, we're jumping into, boys, football's
it's back
this Thursday, August 1st. Yes, it's not technically the preseason, but kind of the preseason. The Hall of Fame game is coming to our televisions. Boys, football is again.
It is.
Oh,
a round of applause,
everyone. I don't care who you are. I don't care if you like the sport. You better just goddamn clap your hands because this is the best time of the
country. W's in the chat, yes. Baby.
100%. And to just, you know, cap off on some of the Hall of Fame inductees for this 2024 season, we got, dude, this made your boy feel pretty old. Julius Peppers.
Yeah.
And hey, shout out the boy, Antonio Gates.
Yeah.
Some of the two notable inductees coming in this August 3rd, 2024 enshrinement ceremony. So boys, we're getting old, man, because I remember when Antonio Gates and Julius Peppers were balling.
Dude.
Absolutely balling.
Wait. Oh, wait, you said, who was the second one?
Antonio Gates, baby.
Okay, on my list, I don't see him listed as one of them.
Yeah, I think he missed the cut. I think he missed the cut in the latest poll. I got little Dwight Freeney. That big boy. Scary man.
I got Randy Gardish.
Yeah, he was a little bit before our time. I don't know a whole lot about him.
Linebacker
for the Broncos.
Linebacker for the Denver Broncos. And then I got Devin Hester.
Yeah, fan favorite right there. Wow. Fan favorite.
Unreal.
Yeah.
Then we got Andre
Johnson. That's cool to see.
Jeez, bro. That makes
me feel Yeah, bad. That's when we and first then, started getting into football. I know.
And then we got Steve McMichael.
Yeah, another early bird. Yeah.
Defensive tackle, Chicago Bears. And then these last, so Julius Peppers, Penna, what you said in the beginning.
Unreal.
And then the final one on my list that I got is Patrick
Willis. Dude.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Wow, bro. Those two.
Some of those guys, like
Patrick Willis, man, I feel like he ended his career like way
too early. Because of that injury, bro. Remember the one in the NFC Championship game at the goal line? He snaps his leg to try to stop the tackle, and that was kind of, good try, buddy, but bye-bye.
Absolute animal.
You just walked those off.
No. The bitch fucking bent three times backwards.
Oh, my leg!
Dude, that's a solid inductee right there. All of them.
He got freaking ousted. Yeah. Out of that.
Those are some dudes. Those seven right there, I'm like, oh my God, bro. That is a freaking lineup if I've seen.
Okay, but.
Yeah. And this will be the first Hall of Fame game on ESPN.
Yeah. Which is exciting.
First, right? Breaking some
But how do we feel about Caleb Williams not playing in this game, even for like a series? He's already come out and basically said negative on playing. I'm going to just keep it all till the beginning of the season.
Yeah, that's kind of like the trend nowadays, is right? A lot of the preseason guys just don't play. I'm sorry, like the starters, right? They don't play during the preseason. like back in the day, like, you know, every, you know, first game, first quarter, they get five snaps, right? And it progressively right. goes on.
But I yeah, can nowadays see,
they don't play.
I wasn't shocked by it. I thought maybe once their first, like, preseason game comes that he might play in that. But I didn't – this game being so, like, early – I could see why. Like, they just started training camp, like, what, 2 weeks ago or something yeah. like that? So, like, they haven't really been, like, going hard at it. And, like, God forbid he gets hurt.
Yeah, but...
in, like, the Hall of Fame.
Just to take, you know, first series or, you know, I mean, the chances of the first series going past three downs, slim to none.
They said that about Aaron Rodgers that opening week last
yeah,
year.
Yeah, there's that guy.
But that was, granted, that was week one, so.
But it should be good. I'm excited to see everything that Houston has to offer, what kind of depth chart they got this season. They got out a lot of players. I know a lot of players probably won't play, but I'd love to see how the Texans line up this coming season, being a big-time rival to the boys over in Tennessee, baby.
You guys see, I saw a clip, you brought up the Texans, of Tank Dell walking out onto the practice field, and some fan was on the sidelines, and he was like, "Yo, Tank Dell, sign my arm, I'm going to get it tatted right now if you sign it." And Tank Dell's like, on God, no way. And he went over, signed it, sure enough, like the next post, the dude had the full on, he tattooed his signature.
Wow.
Or on his leg or whatever.
Don't you love that?
I mean, that receiving core could get
very scary.
Potentially, he's the number three.
Something to think about, dude. I mean, to be honest, Tank Dell, Nico Collins, Stephon Diggs, and Dalton Schultz. A lot of weapons.
And
don't forget big old Jobo. Dude, they could be a very scary team. I mean, they're in our fucking division, but
everyone keeps forgetting about the Joe Mixon signing because they got this stack of receiving core. I'm like, bro, they got weapons everywhere.
That's gonna be scary.
Joe Mixon's got some tread, but still dynamic from, you know. Still, I mean, shoot, I'd love to have him behind Alvin.
Well, folks, let's see if you guys like the Hall of Fame game. Let's see who gets in. Who's you're voting for on getting into this this year's nominations for Hall of Fames?
Again, August 1st, which is what, Thursday yep. at 8 p.m. Eastern Central Time or whatever it is.
That's Eastern Standard Time. And
Eastern Standard.
Texans versus the Chicago Bears.
Good old Bear.
Going on to our next segment, man, with this new release coming out this about 10 days ago, we got to touch on College Football 25, boys. It's, you know, I've seen a lot of the gameplay. Unfortunately, I don't have a PS5, so the boy hasn't tested it out yet. But, hey, that's another reason that freaking Sony's, like, taking more out of my money is they're like, hey, you're gonna have to play this, get that PS5 or Xbox, what is it, Xbox One Series, whatever.
Yeah, only the new Xbox and only the PS5.
Yeah,
Xbox Series X.
That's very, very unfortunate. I mean, I've seen tons of clips, people playing Road to Glory and Expedition, but surprisingly enough, Road to Glory is probably my favorite
game
mode. The Dynasty mode, most popular right now with the pre-sales. 45% of the majority of time players are spent is on it, just in that game mode. So guys are just stacking up teams, which is great. When I get the ultimate team, it's freaking, I'm getting absolutely eaten alive.
Did you guys see how much that they've made already?
Through the roof. Oh, bro. Mind blowing.
Dude, it's crazy.
So they were, what is it? So far up until this point, about 5 hours ago, They were projecting that making $150 million in revenue was a success to them for the game. Currently, right now, as of 5 hours ago, they're up to $500
million. Wow. Gosh, dude. Big for the program. Bro. Big for the program.
Real. And you know, that's taking into account, well, not revenue, but like net income. You know, each player that opted in got $600. That was like part of, like, you know, EA's and NCAA like negotiations. Each player that's you know, name, image, and likeness is in the game, $600, and they get a free copy.
Oh yeah!
So like, take those costs into effect, and how much revenue they're bringing in, bro. It's, you know, it's tough to see them because the top dog, especially in the EA field, is unfortunately FIFA, which is like probably the least favorite of my games. But like worldwide, people love soccer, and that's always the heavy hitter. But yeah, it's good to see freaking college. And again, when they come out with, you know, new series and new seasons, I only think they're going to grow even more.
I mean, absolutely. The way that this thing planned out, the way the graphics look, gameplay, yeah. I mean, they outdid themselves to Madden. A lot of people are trying to compare it to it, but they hit the hammer on the nail. They did not miss here at all.
And how weird is it going to be to have, like, because obviously, like, esports, like, it's big in, you know, collegiate athletics now. And it's going to be so weird to, like, you're on the, you know, Ohio State esports game, and you're playing NCAA, and you're playing, and then you go and, like, watch the game, literally the real game in, like, a couple hours, and you're like, holy shit, hey, bro, pass it to freaking the X every time, run this play, it works every time. That's going to be a weird dynamic to see from, like, video game to, like, real life instantaneously.
Well, yeah, they've had a lot of, like, big people already playing it. I've seen Sketch play a bunch of, like, high-end people, like, a lot of, like, influencers, obviously. I've seen Shane Gillis play another comedian the other day. I think it was on, like, ESPN or something like that, too. I was like, this game, there ain't nobody that does this with, like, games that drop. And now they're just, like, already playing games on ESPN and stuff like that. I'm like, oh, my God, this game is that big already. No,
it is. It's huge. It's awesome to see it. Awesome to see.
Now, what we could see here coming in the future, if this does play out, and this would be huge for a lot of gamer collegiates, is this brings scholarships on Road to Glories.
100%.
Brings it out. EA Sports getting bigger and bigger. We've seen that take a big turn in esports this year and last year. So this could be another game on the market for scholarships going forward. That would be huge. The more money, the merrier, baby.
Hey, you're a dual athlete.
Wouldn't that be something, bro?
Hey, watch, bro. Watch these young bucks come up and be like, yo, I'm nasty. I'm 5-star and I'm a freaking, you know, elite tier one.
That would be awesome.
Do they automatically get, like, the 99 overall if they do that? If they're D1 and they're, like, top 5 in the world at the game.
Right. Their focus attributes probably like 99, yeah. Or like their knowledge, but
they might have to add a game stat, gaming. What is their stat in
gaming? Bro, hey, bench this clown. He sucks at gaming. He's too much in that freaking scout book.
Stepping on over to a different side that we haven't seen that I'm happy to hear about, happy to see. We're getting on over to what the PGA Tour is stepping into, this new YouTube golf world, for the first time. Some of the most popular golf creators from around the world will face off in the Creator Classic, a 9-hole competition at East Lake Golf Club in Atlanta before the Tour Championship. That's going to be going on the week of the 29th all the way to the 1st, I believe. That's going to be Memorial Day weekend. But they're going to face off that Wednesday. Winner of that will have a chance to actually play the Tour Championship. So 16 of the most successful and skilled golf creators take on the newly restored. Remember, they've done a lot of work to this place. You got guys from Dude Perfect, Tyler Toney, fan favorite, love him. The Brian Bros, Fat Perez. That guy's an absolute stick from Bob Diz Sports. And then Good getting on in there with Garrett Clark, Brad Dalkey, and Sean Walsh. From my understanding, it is stroke play. And then it's going to be a playoff between the top four finishers. The foursome will be announced the day before the event. What are we thinking, boys?
Hey, this is our opportunity that everyone's been watching. Okay, like, we obviously all see these influencer, you know, social media golfers, but let's see you go do it in tournament play, right? And then, hey, if you win it, let's see you against the dudes, right? Because, yeah, I mean, you know, I'm assuming a lot of those guys don't take second cuts, but we never know. And again, the pressure of playing in a tournament to, you know, doing it out there with the boys is a lot different. So it'll be a great idea to see, okay, what's the, you know, above average, super above average golfer compared to the tour?
They're obviously that was my first thing is like, okay, now we actually get to see them do, because usually when you watch their videos and stuff, like, you don't know what's edited, what they shot before that or whatever. Now we can like really see like firsthand, like, oh God, bro. Like,
yeah.
Shank four.
100%.
But again, like, watching some of these guys before, like, they don't seem bad, so I don't think it's going to be that bad of a tournament. Like, I'm sure there's going to be some dudes out there that actually know how to strike the ball.
Oh, totally.
Put and do some really nice shots. Going into the other tournament, though, I don't see them doing very good against the actual.
Well, so to that, and then I'll let you take it there, Mr. Olson. So about a week or two ago, little Grant Horvat, he took on Phil Mickelson head-to-head in 18 holes. The wager is if that he won, he had to wear his joggers brand, like golf joggers, which Phil Mickelson hates pants. And sure enough, Grant Horvat, a YouTube golfer, beat Phil, absolutely sticked him out. I think he went minus two on the day, and Phil ended up shooting even.
Yeah, I think I would say that Grant's probably, in my opinion, the best of, like, the influencer golfer guys. Like, he played collegiate golf.
He did. Right? He played collegiate golf, yep.
Yeah, and he was a dude. Like, but going back on, you know, if that guy, the guy who makes it into the tour, imagine the odds on him.
Through the roof. They got to be so high.
Bro. Okay, I'm going to throw $100. I'm going to be a 10 trillionaire.
Legit.
Now, it's the back nine of East Lake, right?
Fully restored.
Correct. Sure, okay. Play. Yep.
And it's 16, but they're in groups of four?
No, they'll probably still go off in twosomes. They'll probably do twosomes, and then they'll all follow suit behind each other and finish out. Because that's like when the pros do their practice day. That's usually when they do. So they'll probably do the pros, let the pros get out, do their practice day, and then have that event in the afternoon. So people at home could probably watch, tune into that. Because it has taken big time. I mean, talking about Bob Does Sports, you know, just a channel 2 years ago about Funny Golf, all of those guys, including Fat Perez, Joey Da, like, those guys have now moved to Florida, do it full time, make great money, just like Good. They travel everywhere. You know, you got Busted Jack, a lot of big channels getting into this. So to give them a highlighted chance to see who's the guy in the creators world, it's going to be exciting to see. I think we're all going to like that.
Totally.
They should do something like that for football.
No, they had that for a little bit. Remember, like, average
Yes. pros? That was classic.
Versus Joe's? Bro.
Guys would get killed out there.
Dude, I think James Harrison was on one episode. Like,
destroyed.
Hey, get my bag. I'm freaking out of here.
I remember them putting cushions down, like, oh, we're going to help the blow. Like, no, you're not. You're still getting hit by a fucking rhino. Good try.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, for our last segment on the Brotherhood, we are going to dive in, give you some updates with the Paris 2024 Olympics. Let's go, USA!
USA!
USA! And currently, right now, as we are recording, USA is currently in the lead, holding 26 medals.
Yikes.
Second would be France with 18. Oh, God. 26, 18 for a second? What's going on? And then third, you got China with 14. Okay. Now, I will say this. USA does not hold the most golds.
Right.
We only have four golds right now. France has five, and China has six.
Okay.
We got four golds, 11 silvers, and 11 bronzes right now for USA. France has 5 golds, 9 silvers, 4 bronzes, and China has 6 golds, 6 silvers, and 2 bronzes. Okay. So, I mean,
is it quality over quantity or quantity over quality?
So would you rather have more medals overall or just more golds?
Or like, both. Let's get both.
Well,
why not both USA?
Definitely, I think one of the events that clearly goes to the USA is swimming. We have two. We have two golds. Yeah. We have seven silvers and six bronzes in swimming itself.
Yeah. We're just dominating.
Nice in the pool.
Hey, but we're also surprisingly really good at fencing. We have a gold in fencing, silver, and bronze in the old fencing.
I watched the fencing today with the girls.
It's very intriguing.
Like, I don't even know how they score points on this thing. But hey,
USA, USA.
That's how you score points. You just stab people. Juggler shots are worth 10.
And then obviously I think everyone that was tuning into this year's Olympics had their biggest eye on like the USA women's gymnastics. Mm-hmm. The team as a team took home gold, I think yesterday or today earlier. But I mean, I watched all of that one and dude, our girls are disgusting out there. They hit everything just perfectly. Good. I'm like, oh, and then Simone Biles, the amount of air that that woman can
just
get off
the springboard
blows my mind. I'm bunnies. Like, how is she that high?
No, she got bunnies. No. Shout out Simone Biles. She's an absolute freaking stud. And,
yeah, she was a couple she was of, killing it.
Another event I was, you know, peeking in on was the U.S. Women's Beach Volleyball squad. Hey. Both the chicks, Kelly Chang and I think it's Sarah Hughes, both SoCal chicks, man. Fullerton and Costa Mesa.
Ain't that something?
So shout out the beach volleyball studs out there representing USA and also SoCal.
Yes, good. Yes. And I also wanted to shout out, I don't know if you guys watch any of these, but I've been watching the women's rugby. These girls they're like... Dude, they would run me over out there.
Oh,
like,
dude,
some of these girls are scary out there. But our women's team took home bronze, and that was that was the first time ever in history that the USA won a medal in rugby.
Okay.
And did you see how they won it?
No, I didn't.
Last 20 seconds of the game, they're down by it was 7-12, and I don't really know how the scoring goes, but I know if you go in between the posts, it's like more points or whatever.
Okay.
They pretty much had to go through the posts, and we're on like our own 10, and this chick like shrugs two tackles and houses it full field to go through the posts, tie the game. They kick the extra point, we win it. So totally stole it from them. But the girl on, because they were playing
Australia.
Mm-hmm. Madison Levy or
Levi.
Levi. Madison Levi. This chick had 17 scores in all the games total. I watched a highlight clip of her. If you guys can go look it up, go look up Madison Levi on Australia, women's rugby. Bro, this girl, every time she touched the ball, just housing it, just outrunning these chicks left and right. Yeah. I was like, oh my God, what, this chick could play in the American Football League right now and dust people.
I love it. And the only other event that I'm kind of peeking my eye at is, and it's postponed right now, so we'll have to wait on the results of it, but that men's and women's surfing. The men's side, man, this guy, that Gabriel Medina, he's a Brazil competitor. Freaking two-time, you know, World Surfing League champion. You know, he's probably the dude right now. And he's obviously, he's made it past round three. He's advanced to the quarterfinals. So he's kind of the odds-on favorite right now to win that the men's side. But, you know, surfing's, and it's in Tahiti, right? It's not obviously played in France, right? They're actually doing it in Tahiti right now, one of the big big wave beaches. And then on the women's side, they have the, hey, shout out USA. We got Carissa Moore, gold medalist from Tokyo 2020. And, she won that in the women's shortboard event. So she's an absolute stud. So hopefully, the women, they haven't done their round three. So I think their round three is being postponed. So, but she is in the round three. So hopefully, Carissa Moore can pull it home for the United States.
And then the, this Saturday, which I've always been a fan of, women's vault final. Should be held this one. See who's going to bring that home. What kind of acrobatic things are we going to see? I guess we're going to find out.
True that.
I want to see the break dancing, or they're calling it breaking or whatever it is, but it doesn't start for like a week or two.
New event. Yep. New Olympic event right there. Break dancing.
Yeah.
We're probably not going to win that one. There's some countries that have some pretty damn good break dancers.
But we also...
No.
Okay. Yeah, go on.
I was going to say, yeah, because when you're talking about certain events, freaking Japan took home like all three golds for judo.
Yeah, they did. They did. It wasn't even fun.
Yeah. Okay. I was like, okay.
Which, talking so, Sunday...
No one can fuck with them.
Sunday, we also get to see the first round of golf kickoff, but we also get to see the first rounds of boxing diving in. And women's and men's on Sunday the 4th. Sunday the 4th, we get to see that. Sunday's going to be a good day.
Hell yeah.
And then men's basketball, they've already played one game, have they? Or two? Or have they even started?
I don't think they've
started
yet.
I keep watching like games, but I don't know if they're reruns or not.
I think they've won one game. I don't know against who, but I think they've won one. Because I have seen those LeBron highlights.
That's right.
Yeah.
They almost lost to fucking South Africa.
Yeah.
No, it was like South Sudan or something. Like, it was like down. Like, they South literally. Sudan. Yeah, if they score, they had the ball with like 7 seconds left, and we were up by one, and they missed the 2-point. And I was like, oh my God, we almost just lost game.
Dude, I didn't realize there was 392 events in this thing. There's so many. Day in, day out.
You know who balled out today in basketball was freaking Wemby.
Dude, I forgot he was on France.
Wet from three, too.
And, dude, they have him and Rudy Gobert. Like, dude, they got, like, their own little, French twin towers over there. Just holding it down.
Yeah, they were. But Japan was sticking around with them. But, I mean, dude, France might
be. Yeah, they won on a four, or they tied on a 4-point play.
Yeah.
France did. They got fouled and freaking hit the free throw.
Yeah, but they, I think they're, like, favored to play USA in the finals, France.
Good. So I want that. I want Wemby to get freaking posterized.
Postered!
Like, you're playing in Wemby's our,
getting
you're playing in our league, bud. All right, can you imagine? Who would be the most likely player on the U.S. team to poster Wemby? I have mine. I'm thinking
Embiid.
Okay.
Or Ant.
I don't know if Joel Love's got that kind of bunny over, I mean, size-wise, but I think, Ant, I'm thinking Ant's.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing, dude.
Maybe easy money.
Okay, if I could definitely see it, but, you know, maybe like KD freaking 10 years ago, 8 years ago.
We just need KD to go down and LeBron, like, step on his back and then posterize him.
If KD really, like, you know, because we've seen KD freaking obviously posterize guys. If he, like, got back to that on Wemby, oh, my God, iconic.
Yeah, that would be dope.
Dude, the Durantula, come on.
Okay. But I think as far as right now, yeah, we're still holding it down. 26 medals, France 18, and China with 14. So, next week, we'll update you guys with the medals. Hopefully, we can just keep this lead. I mean, we got an 8. What is that? Yeah, 8-point medal lead right now. I mean, not the most golds, but hey, most medals so far, baby.
Yeah. Bring in more medals. Hey, we'll sprinkle in some golds. We're right back.
And just get a little shout out. We haven't seen her in years. Singing on top of an Eiffel Tower. Celine Dion with the opening ceremony was absolutely phenomenal.
Way to hold it down there, Celine.
Well, folks, that's going to do it for this week's episode. We hope y'all enjoyed. Stay tuned for more highlights, what's going on with the Olympics. We'll be bringing more content, TikTok, YouTube. You know where to find us. Hit that like, smash that comment button, and don't forget to share. We're always here for y'all. But until next time, take care. Stay safe.
Adios, muchachas and muchachos.
Deuces.